Hello everyone and welcome to NAC Graphics. We are doing the chapter of transform function, and in the last 6 videos we have covered up all the related options. Along with all the options we did for transformation, Illustrator also provides you a freehand utility to transform objects, which is this free transform tool. Let's explore the functions of this tool. I'm starting with this rectangle here. I select the free transform tool, and as you turn it on, you have a panel of 4 buttons. I'm starting with this button here, which is free transform button itself. Now notice the mouse pointer as I hover it over the rectangle. This pointer will scale the shape from its corner like this. As I hover the pointer ahead, it is turned to a curved pointer, which means it will now rotate the object like this. As I hover ahead and come over this center anchor point, the pointer turns to be a cross button. If you drag from here to right or left direction, it will shear the object horizontally like this. And if you move your pointer up or down, it is gonna scale its height. Then hovering mouse pointer ahead, again we have rotate option, and then at the corner we have that same 3 pointer cursor to scale the shape from the corner. Then coming over this anchor point, dragging left or right will scale its width, and dragging up or down will shear it vertically. While scaling the shape from the corner, press shift key to scale it proportionately like this. And pressing shift key while rotating will constrain the rotating angle by 45 degrees. Instead of pressing shift key, you can click this constrain button here. It gets highlighted when you enable it. Now if you scale it from here, it will scale proportionately, and if you rotate, it will rotate with a constrained angle of 45 degrees. You can also set the axis point by dragging this mark over the desired place, like here I drag this mark over here to set it as the reference point, and now if I rotate it, it will rotate around this point. Then third button here is of Prospective Distort, which will distort the shape to give a look like this, which is useful for making perspective artworks. While working with this tool, if you pick this point to distort and move horizontally towards right or left, the corresponding horizontal point, which is this, will also get distort in the opposite behavior. Like if you move it to the right side, then this point moves to the left side. You move it towards left, then this point moves towards right. Similarly, this thing works when you move this point vertically. If I move up, this corresponding point is gonna come down. And if I move it down, this is gonna go upwards. Alright? Then at last we have free distort button, which will distort every point independently, like this. So this is all about free transform tool, and with this, the chapter of transform is over. We have discussed each and everything about the transform function in 7 videos, including this one. And I hope this topic is clear to you. Thanks for watching NAC Graphics. Hit like and share if you find it good, and subscribe for more upcoming tutorials.